baseball player Lou Gehrig. Up next.
Treasured friends, today we are honored to present part one of a two-part series entitled Remembering Past Lives, Baseball Prodigy Christian Haupt, with Miss Solange Mora from Samara in Nicoya, Costa Rica. Miss Mora has a love of education and many years of experience in teaching children and the disabled. She has a bachelor's degree in the art of education from the National University of Costa Rica and certifications in Braille and early childhood development. In Costa Rica, she worked with blind high school students and adults at the Helen Keller Institute and helped them to be more independent. She has also traveled to different areas of Costa Rica with a diverse working team of social workers, psychologists, and teachers to help to enhance the quality of life of the visually impaired. Since coming to the U.S., Ms. Mora has taught preschool and primary school children. She is currently a teacher at Bambini Montessori in Nashville, Tennessee, teaching students ages 3 to 6 using the Montessori method of education, which celebrates and nurtures each child's intrinsic desire to learn.
Hola, encantadores televidentes. Soy Solange Mora desde Samara en Nicoya, Costa Rica. La efervescente Costa Rica celebra la bondad interna inherente a cada persona en nuestro planeta. Parece que como Christian Haupt, de 9 años de edad, de Santa Bárbara, California, Estados Unidos, nació para jugar béisbol. Como niñito, pasó incontables horas jugando con un bate y una pelota de juguete. Cuando tenía solamente 2 años de edad, sus padres se asombraron de sus habilidades y tomaron un video jugando su deporte favorito y lo publicaron en YouTube. El comediante reconocido mundialmente Adam Sandler vio el video e inmediatamente le ofreció al pequeñín una actuación especial en la película Ese es mi chico. A medida que pasaba el tiempo, las habilidades y la fama del béisbol de Christian crecieron. Unos pocos años después, su cumpleaños número 4, se convirtió en la persona más joven en lanzar el primer picheo ceremonial en un partido de las ligas mayores de béisbol. ¿Por qué Christian es tan apasionado por el béisbol? En el programa de hoy aprenderemos de su madre, Kathy Baird, la sorprendente respuesta.
And it goes back to when he was 2 and 3 years old. He had an aptitude for baseball, and he was quite obsessed with it. He played baseball morning, noon, and night. Around that same time, he started saying, "Mommy, I used to be a tall baseball player." And I said, "Yeah, you will be a tall baseball player someday." And it got to the point where he got really frustrated with me and said, "No, I was tall like Daddy." And one day I kind of got what he was trying to tell me. And I said, "You mean like you were a grown-up?" And he said, "Yes." So he kept telling me stories. When we filmed the movie with Adam Sandler in Boston, he happened to see a big picture of Babe Ruth when we were at the baseball stadium. And he got so upset by this photo, he started waving his little bat and saying, "I don't like him. He was mean to me." And it was strange, but at the time it was still, you know, I still didn't know really what he was trying to tell me. We came back, he turned 3, and that's when he started coming up with specific details where I started to take it more seriously. And what he was alluding to was a past life as a baseball player. And the only reason I knew it was in that era of 1920, 1930 was first of all because he referred to Babe Ruth. But the second thing that really got me was we were in an elevator, and he said, "Mommy, this elevator looks like a hotel." Mm-hmm. And I said, "Yeah, it kind of does." And he said, "When I was a tall baseball player, when I was tall like Daddy, I used to stay in hotels almost every night. And I kind of joking, even at that point, I thought, okay. And I said, did you fly on airplanes? And he immediately said, no, mostly trains. You know, and so I didn't know anything about Babe Ruth or baseball, period. So I would go and I would Google these things and I put in Babe Ruth travel on trains. And sure enough, Babe Ruth traveled on trains. So I did more research and I came across a woman named Carol Bowman, who wrote a book called Children's Past Life Memories. And Carol had been documenting cases of children between the ages of 2 to 6 who displayed exactly the same characteristics and behaviors that our son had, like his aptitude for baseball, very specific memories that were often conveyed to me at night right before bed or right after he woke up from a nap, just that had a lot of emotion attached to them. There's another thing consistent with all the children who tell past life stories. They are generally, it's not a make-believe type conversation. It's a very serious, almost like adult-like tone where they shift and you really can tell they're not fantasizing. So Carol was very helpful to me. She is the one who suggested that I start showing him photographs. So she said, take some pictures of Babe Ruth's team and show it to him and see what he has to say. So I waited until he was groggy and tired right before bed, because that's when he always brought up things about his baseball life. And I showed him the pictures and I said, do you see anybody in here who doesn't like Babe Ruth? And he immediately pointed to a tall guy with dimples. And I showed him another picture and he did the same thing. And then he said, that's me. So I went to bed right away. Yeah, I didn't want to think about that right away. It was a little bit scary almost. You know, it was very disturbing to have your child say that he was someone else. I didn't know who that person was at the time. And I went and did some research and found out it was a man named Lou Gehrig. He insisted on wearing his baseball uniform every single day. There was a good, you know, 2-year period where we could not get him out of a baseball uniform. And so basically, as time went by, I began to accept it more, even though it was very much in contrast with my religious beliefs. You know, being a Christian and coming from that background, it was something that I wasn't totally comfortable with, the idea of reincarnation. And so it set me on a bit of a spiritual journey of discovery, where I went in search of answers, right? I was kind of on a quest to figure it out.
Tomaremos un momento para agradecer a la divinidad por nuestros viajes espirituales aquí en la Tierra. Volveremos enseguida. Bienvenidos a la parte 1 de la serie de 2 partes Recordando vidas pasadas, el prodigio del béisbol, Christian Haupt, presentando una entrevista con la madre de Christian, Kathy Baird, en su búsqueda para aprender más acerca de la habilidad de su hijo para recordar su vida pasada. La señora Baird visitó a muchos expertos.
So when Christian turned 5, I reached out to a man named Dr. Jim Tucker. And he is the head of neurobehavioral psychology at the University of Virginia School of Medicine. And the Department of Medicine there has documented over 3,000 cases of children who recall past lives since Dr. Ian Stevenson started the work in 1967. Dr. Tucker made a trip to California to our house to meet Christian and to meet myself and my husband. And while he was at our house, Christian said, I chose her to be my mom. And it was something he'd never said to me before, and I didn't know what to make of it. But Dr. Tucker got really interested and started asking him questions about it. And he said, well, where was she when you chose her? And he said, being born, as in I was being born. And then he said, where were you? And he said, in the sky. So the thing that made it so interesting was afterwards, Dr. Tucker told me that many of these children who recall past lives recall choosing their parents and have very specific memories around when they chose their parents. And what it did, because Christian, you know, up until the age of five, had always told me that I was Lou Gehrig's mother, which I really didn't pay much attention to, but he looked at pictures of the mother and said, "Mommy, you were her." And I always just thought that was his way of assimilating the two worlds, you know, his past life with his present life. It would make sense. He would mesh us into one person, right? But after that visit from Dr. Tucker, I got really curious about that. And I thought, gosh, was I Lou Gehrig's mother? But it got me curious. And so literally 1 week later, I did my first past life regression and went immediately into the life of Lou Gehrig's mother, Christina Gehrig, Mom Gehrig, as they called her. And I was in her body. I could feel the weight on my body. I described details of being at Yankee games, of watching Lou Gehrig retire from baseball with amazing details. Like, I could hear the popping of the cameras were actually hurting my ears. The flashes on the cameras, apparently, which I didn't know what that was at the time. I researched all of this stuff later. But a lot of the details that came through in I did three past life regressions ultimately. Many of the details I could only verify by ordering death certificates, birth certificates, because I spoke in detail about children who Lou Gehrig's mother had lost, when they died, how they died. And surprisingly, when I got the death certificates, it was all accurate.
El libro de Kathy Baird, El niño que sabía demasiado, una historia verdadera asombrosa de los recuerdos de la vida pasada de un niño, está disponible en Amazon.com.
Encantadores televidentes, gracias por su compañía hoy para la parte 1 de nuestra serie de dos partes, Recordando vidas pasadas, el prodigio del béisbol, Christian Haupt.